Wander has a gigantic ego, just huge. She doesn't even do the culturally normal thing of changing her name to her host name. No, no, no. Wander is just too good for that. She's just too unique.
It is your destiny.
Fuck my destiny.
Sarkisian returned my call. We'll meet about selling the Turk.
You still got it? When's the meeting?
Tomorrow morning.
Meaning this news could have waited?
I'm Jashykins, and welcome back to my The Host Rant. Now, last episode, I thought I was done talking about Wander. At least I'd be able to go, you know, maybe one or two videos without mentioning her, or at least not focusing on her. But then, after I filmed it, after I edited it, I look back at the outline and I realize we have another Wanderer-centric episode. Now, listen, I like some melodrama, and at the beginning of The Host, the melodrama is the sort of good, cheesy kind, and so you don't really mind, at least I didn't, mind the talking about how great Wanderer was, for it's Waterdeep and his assistant are putting Wanderer into Malayne's body and they're going, oh my god, Wanderer is like so awesome, man. And the other's like, yeah, man, she's never been in the same host body twice and she's been to like 9 different planets. Oh my god, man, that's amazing. And you know, it's sort of funny because it is building Wander up to be this kick-ass character. And then you see her and she is a whiny alien that's like a teenager. And oh my god. Yeah, you'd get something totally different from what you expected. That's like if in The Terminator when Kyle Reese is warning Sarah Connor, he's a machine. He's going to come after you. He's going to kill you. Terminators are foot soldiers of Skynet. They don't eat or sleep. They feel no pity or pain. And then you see Arnold Schwarzenegger and he's wearing a tutu and holding some roses and singing My Favorite Things. All that buildup for nothing. You know, you'd be really disappointed of that happening. And, oh, jeez. Yeah, and that's what Wander is doing in the book. She's got built up to such an epic level, and then you see her interactions, and you're like, can someone just kill her? Please, for the love of God, someone kill her. And unfortunately, she's the main character in a Stephanie Meyer book, which means everything works out for her and nothing works out for the reader. Also, you know those situations like you're in a fancy restaurant and there's too many forks, too many knives, too many spoons, and there's some utensils that you think were far in the future from existing. And there's really no reason for that except tradition. That's how things have always been done. I'm sure there is some reason, but it's really obscure and makes no sense to the average person. That's sort of what the souls have in that they take the name of their host. I don't know why. They just do. They just do it. I have no clue why. They just take the name of their host. And sometimes they'll keep the name of past hosts. But oh no no, that is too cool for Wanderer. She decides to use the name Wanderer and not fit in and, you know, use her host name like everyone else. Now listen, there are two reasons, in my opinion, that people break traditions. One is because they deeply care for something and they feel that tradition is wrong, outdated, and they have facts to back it up. The second reason is the teenager stereotype, in which the reason they're breaking tradition is the fact that they just want to be different from their parents. They want to be individual. And that's the latter is where Wanderer falls. She's just doing stuff because she doesn't believe she fits in and she doesn't want to fit in. So I could understand if she was breaking tradition to make this some great statement, but she's not. She is not trying to do that. She's just like a whiny teenager that wants to be different than her parents. That's all it is, and that's what makes it really annoying. And until next video, goodbye.
Wanderer has a gigantic dick.